guys, Amy here with Leap of Faith Crafting. So today I thought I'd just give you some hacks and some things within Design Space that you might not know are there. If you've been using Design Space for a little bit, some of these things took me a couple years before I even knew they were there. So just in case you didn't know, we are going to start with actually going into settings here. So if you come into settings here, and this is under my dropdown. Again, I'm on a computer, so it might be different on a tablet, something like that. But this is where you can pick, you know, your language, your country, if you want to do what's in beta right now, or if you want to just do what's live. Beta is stuff they're testing out, so we can change that, but I'd have to restart. So right now I have it on beta, you know, your subscription, and then what version you're using. And then your machines, you can also do a new product setup here. You can update your firmware if you need to calibrate your machine before print and cut. And usually Design Space will prompt you to do this when you do a print and cut for the first time on a machine. So you don't need to come in here. Care, you can add some custom material settings. And if you have those cartridges from way back in the day, you can link those here and start to do that. And then on Canvas here, you can do the full grid, which is all of those lines. You can do a partial grid, which is just every inch. So you can see here on my background, it's about every inch now. And then you can do no grid, which is just white. So it depends on how you like to design things. You can change your units here. Load type. So you can change this if you want your own defaults for, you know, if you only say do card mats, you can put on card mat here. I always keep everything at none there. Notifications, just things if you want to turn them on. And then this is just your system of your stuff. Okay, so another thing is how I just showed you can change your grids. You can also change it by clicking on this square up in that left corner right there is the square. If you click on it, you can see that it changes between no grid, the 1-inch grid, and then the quarter inch grids here. So that can save you time when you're doing that. So another thing is, say we're going to do a text here. Something like this, and add an image. And then I'm going to click this plus to add it on my canvas. And then once it's added, you can go to view. Okay, and this is on here. Okay, and then I'm going to change. So another thing about the font is when you go into font, you will have different filters here. And you can click on Cricut, which is just Cricut fonts. These are ones that there's some free ones, plus there's also ones that come with access. And then to get the ones actually over on your system, you're going to want to click System. So this brings up all the fonts you have downloaded on your system, ones that came with your computer, and then other ones that you've downloaded from other sites. I download a bazillion from Creative Fabrica because I have the yearly subscription there. And everything is commercial use. So I know from them, I can use it from commercial use. Cricut has their own licenses on stuff, so you can only do it for a certain amount of things you're making. So I just prefer to use Creative Fabrica for my fonts. Okay, and then there's also the bookmarked. So any of your fonts, say you really like certain fonts because fonts are hard to pick, you can go ahead and click on here and it will bookmark your font. And then when you go into bookmark, you have a smaller range to choose from there. And then you can go into your recent for ones that you've recently used. Okay, but even within these fonts, you can filter it here. You know, all caps, kerned, and I don't know why my screen is whiting out. That's so weird. Never had that happen. But just showing you, here's all the different filters within here, writing, handwritten, free. So you can filter more by that, and language, okay, things like that. Okay, but I wanted to show you, if you're in here, you can see what your font is up here. But let's change it to my rainbow. Okay, so the one thing with fonts, especially script fonts, before you cut these, You can see how these little black lines are in here. Those will be cut, so you always want to combine, weld these together. So I'm going to go into combine and go on weld. And so now all those little lines disappear. So make sure you do that before you ever cut anything that is script out of pretty much anything. I don't know if there's anything you would cut it out that you don't want it welded. Okay, so make sure that's welded. Okay, so the other thing that is great is you can get these little red exclamation points. That means that this is too big. So right now I have my joy selected. So this is saying if I click on it, it's too large, and it tells me what to reduce it to. Okay, but if I change this to my Explore 3, then that goes away because there's different sizes. That's a bigger machine, so you can cut different things. So I love those little exclamation points now and not having to go back and figure out, oh my gosh, what size does it actually have to be that we used to do. Okay, so the other thing, now that it's welded and becomes its own image, you can see that we don't have that font here anymore. So a lot of times you'll be like, oh my gosh, what was that font that I just used? I want to edit it or something like that. So what you can do is actually right click over here on the layers panel. And down here, you get the image info. And so if you go over here, my selected font was rainbow. So that's really great to have, because then I can remember what that is without having to go back. Okay, so the other thing I wanted to show you actually was the contour tool, which this one took me forever to figure out, but now it's one of my favorite tools. The great thing about it is if you have something like this that has different parts in it that aren't attached, you can actually remove them. So say I didn't want all these hearts in here. I can hit my contour tool down here on that right side. And what comes up, it always has one selected here. But say I don't want that heart, I can click on it, click on this heart, and you'll see that it shows up highlighted over on this section and that it actually deletes here on my picture. Just make sure I want to hit the hearts there. Say that I want that actually cut out. So you can change how the image is with the contours here. So that's a great way to kind of personalize stuff. You know, like this one again, we can come in, you know, you can delete the whole outline if you want. And so then you're just left with the inside of cutting out. You might prefer that. So it's just a fun tool to play with. Okay, so that's another fun tool to kind of play around with. Color Sync is one of my favorite panels here. Cricut cuts things out based on colors, puts it on different mats that are different colors. So you can see even in here that this V is not the same as the LOE. It is a different color for some reason. So super easy way to change things is just to click on this and I can drag it up here and then it changes that color to that. So now all of these will cut on the same map, all of these will cut on and this one. And again, if I want to change the color, I can just drag that too. Just be mindful on your mats is that you can only choose one material. So say I wanted this Hello out of adhesive vinyl, and everything else out of cardstock, would not be a good idea to add them to the same mat because you can only choose that one material on there. Okay, so that's just one of the easier ways to use the Color Sync panel. It's nice to see before you go to make it how many mats you're looking at here, and then easy to kind of change the colors. You can always click the color box up here to change it, and the nice thing is that it has the colors that are already used within your design. So if you want to just go back and forth, and then also has the advanced feature that you can put your own hex codes in here. This is important if you're going to be doing print and cuts. Say you have your own, you know, your brand colors and things like that. The mats themselves don't matter. You know, Cricut doesn't know if you put red cardstock or adhesive, you know, the specific color on a mat. So even though this is red, I can cut it out of, you know, black glitter vinyl if I want. So Cricut doesn't know exactly what color on there you're using. But if you wanted to make it a print then cut, So if we go up to basic cut and change this to print then cut, then that color would matter because it is going to print on your printer just like this is. Okay, so another fun thing that you can use is if you're, let's grab a square in here. Say we're making like a shadow box or something, and our shadow box is 8 inches. I'm just going to actually change that up here. We can actually turn this into a guide. And so what a guide does is it just gives us the outline of the shape. So then we can size, say we're going to put this in it. We can actually now size this in here, and this will not cut out. So if we left it out as a square, then you just have to go hide it. But with this, the guide, you don't have to delete it off or hide it before cut it. Other thing is, yeah, you can hide anything on here. So if I wanted to go make all this, but I didn't want to make this yet, but I didn't want to delete it off, you can always hide it and it doesn't delete off, but it won't cut out. Okay, so those are just kind of a few fun tips that you might not have known about within Design Space. So if you have some other tips and tricks, I would love to hear about them. So anyway, thanks for stopping by and happy crafting.